The biggest thing for us last year was we played in meaningful games again, you know, and I think that was the highlight of our season, to be able to beat Drury here at home and obviously beat Lewis here at home, two teams that have kind of had our number in the league the last couple of years, was a great step forward for us.
From a macro program standpoint, it wasn't just the victories for Quincy University that mattered, but just as much by the hardscrabble manner in which they were earned.
I think in the progress of the program and taking that next step, part of that process, Chris, is learning how to win. And I think in some respects we did that this year. You know, obviously we faced injuries with Austin Downing going down and really hurt us there late in the year. But I was really pleased with, I thought we learned how to win. I thought we competed. I thought we played extremely hard in every game. And you know, just learning that process of learning how to win big games.
Ryan Hellenthal was encouraged as well by specific instances of player development growth as well.
Tanner Stuckman continues to just get better and better, obviously with a second team all-conference recognition. I thought Charles Collier had a great year for us, being able to shoot the basketball. He's continuing to evolve his game, wants to be better off the bounce, and I think he's doing that, or hopefully he's doing that this summer or this spring. And I think Victor Kovacevic had a nice year for us, especially the second half of the year, made some big shots, took and made some big shots for us, and the two game winners over Lewis and Drury. So I thought our team made progress.
By the same token, 8-12 in GLVC play and just 1-11 on the road isn't nearly good enough. And Hellenthal saw clear windows of opportunity from the bench to improve specific and needed metrics.
I think it's always evolving for us in terms of finding perimeter shooting. You know, I thought the other piece for us, Chris, that was important in addressing recruiting was the depth piece. You know, I thought we had a good 5, 6, 7 guys last year, maybe 8, but we'd like to get that to 9 or 10 where we can be 10 deep and continue to have to play guys less minutes. Tanner Stuckman played an awful lot of minutes last year. Ryan Briscoe on a bum body played a lot of minutes last year. The same with Charles and Vic and Austin. But I think that's what we tried to address. Obviously, we've got a senior-laden class next year, so it was important for me to continue to get high school kids to develop the program and continue to progress in the program. I think we found shooting in that, and I think we found high-character kids who want to be Hawks.
A little deeper dive on the recruiting class. Obviously, you went out and found a couple of swingmen, and Sullivan, who fills a need for you. I don't know how quickly he fills that need, but he does fill a need. Do you like the architecture of what you were able to do, and how important was getting Solomon kind of right off the bat to set the tone for everything else you did in the game?
You know, really important, Chris. I think he was kind of a jump starter to our recruiting class and being able to say, hey, we're going to commit to high school kids in this program. And the thing I like about our kids that we've got commitments from and letters of intent from, Chris, is that they come from great programs. You know, you look at Solomon Gustafson from Rock Island. You look at Jalen Boyd from LaDue, a proud program over in St. Louis. Tyler Stokes comes from Marshall County, Kentucky. And I know a lot of people around here don't know that school, but in Kentucky, it's one of the top 10 basketball programs in the state, you know. And so Paul Zielinkas comes from Riverside Brookfield. They played for a sectional championship this year. And so I think that's when you're trying to elevate a program, we know that those guys have been coached in those programs. They come from proud programs. And I think that's a big part of the recruiting process.
That established a pair of transfers at the point guard position has made that a DEFCON 1 level concern and perhaps pushed incoming freshman Jalen Boyd onto a much faster development track.
You know, we're really high on Jalen Boyd, Chris. I think he's got a great skill set. He's got the mindset of a winner. He's tough. He's physical. Everything you would want in a freshman high school point guard that's coming into a program. Obviously, with losing AD to the transfer, you know, that accelerates his growth a little bit. But we're working relentlessly nonstop every day here now to find a point guard. We continue to want to bring another one in the program and try to at least bring Jalen along a little bit, and instead of having to stick him in the fire right from day one as our starting point guard. So certainly disappointed that AD decided to leave. But again, you know, the transfer wave is kind of the thing in college basketball now, Chris, as you know, and he expressed an interest to me that he might want to use his grad transfer and play his final year somewhere else. And we certainly supported him in that. You know, I want him to be happy at the end of the day. He's going to graduate from Quincy University, and that's the most important thing. And
overall guard depth is a concern as well, given some of the uncertainty surrounding Ryan Briscoe's health.
And that's a work in progress with him to see whether or not he's going to be able to go or not. You know, I think he's gone a couple different directions here this spring and trying to say, hey, I don't think I can go, but I might want to go. And I'll support him on whatever he does, Chris. He's been a warrior for this program on and off the floor.
And not unimportantly, the program returns next season with a proven alpha already in place.
And a kid, another kid that had the opportunity to be a grad transfer, Chris, and showed his loyalty to the program. And I love that about Tanner. He's a Hawk and loves being a Hawk. And just the progress he made this year was unbelievable. Continued to evolve his game. I thought his being able to stretch the floor from three was an area that he really improved on. I thought he went from a good shooter to a great shooter. And I think he's only going to continue to get better as he continues to get stronger. I know that's an emphasis for him in the offseason is, hey, you know, I can add maybe 5, 10, 15 more pounds to my body, and that allows me to do some more things around the basket. But I think the sky's the limit for that kid. And he's going to take this program and be a senior leader for us next year, and just excited about what he can do.